I love to build stuff, but I also love to have pain-free knees. That's why I pumped into Ben from ATG. He's incredible and I also did a lot of his stuff. But I also want to have one of these backwards treadmills. But when I checked the price of the shipment cost, I know I had to do it on my own. So I started with buying this used mechanical treadmill. I think I got it for around 30 euros or something. After the first try, I realized a few things. First of all, this thing sounds like a car accident. I have to fix that. Secondly, there was no real resistance, so I almost slipped. And the incline was also shitty, because it was way too flat. So I also have to think about a solution for that one too. I brainstormed a little bit and found two things I wanted to try very quickly. First, I glued a gray felt that I had left over from my camper conversion onto a normal kitchen sponge, which I then pressed between the spinning wheel and the main body. Then I cut the sponge in two halves so that I can put both halves between both spinning wheels. For the incline, I used two small notepads that I placed underneath the treadmill to get more incline. This kind of worked, but it was not a real stable resistance. So I needed something that puts pressure on the sponge with the felt. And I then basically opened my CAD program and started designing.
I designed a block that I can screw onto the frame, which doesn't look too bulky, but also have a lot of stability. With the treadmill, there is also the screw with the grip on it to secure the folded treadmill, and I will use that screw to press the sponge onto the spinning wheel. And to ensure that I got a bigger pressure rear, I also printed a second part. Coming back to the squeaky annoying sound, I fixed that one with spraying the hell out of the WD-40. So now I will show you how I mounted everything together really quick. Firstly, I marked the holes where I have to drill them. Drilled the two holes, made sure that there are no leftover chips on the edges. Sprayed a little bit of zinc spray to prevent rust. And then I used some M5 or M6 clinch nuts to get a really proper mounting. And then I screwed in the adjustable screw and placed the second 3D printed part. For the incline, I measured the height of the two notepads and designed the 3D printed simple and small part. And after mounting the part, I think we can try it. As you can see, the treadmill is quite silent and feels pretty solid. I now have a really slight resistance, but I can adjust it continuously. Now I do have a quite strong resistance, so I think it works as it should. Let me know what you think.